Thank you, Professor David Young, for a nice introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present the talk devoted to potential games and transportation models. Firstly, I remind some definitions and results of potential games, and after that we go to transportation problem. We consider the some game, Gamma, that is non-cooperative game. We have the set of players, 1, 2, etc., n. We have number of strategies, xi. In transportation models, I will explain the strategy, etc. And we have the set of pair functions for each player I. Pair function depends on the profile of strategies, which we call x, that is x1, etc., xn. Objective of the player is to maximize or minimize, depending on the problem, private payoff. We use the notation xi, x minus I for the profile in which we like to separately consider the strategy xi. Profile X star is the main definition here. Profile X star is Nash equilibrium if for any player I, his payoff, private payoff XI in the profile XI, X minus I star, less or equal that his payoff in the equilibrium. So if the player I like to deviate from the profile X star, his payoff less or equal than his payoff in the equilibrium. And the game gamma is potential if it exists some function p for which we have the following inequality, that the difference of private payoffs for player I is equal the difference of potential functions in the profile when we fix the profile X and change only the strategy of player I. So if we change the strategy of player I from XI to XI prime, the difference of his payoff is equal to the differences of potential. If this function exists, in this case, the game is potential. That is example of, maybe I show only one example and skip other examples. So this game is related with traffic jamming. Suppose that players 1 and 2 deliver two packages from point A to B. The delay in the first road and in the second road are the delay is different and depends on the number of packages on the channel. For example, here 1, 2, 3, 4, it corresponds to delays if only one package is following by this way, two packages, three packages, and four packages. And at the bottom also, if one package is following by second road, the delay is 2, if two packages 4, in 3 6, etc. So if we calculate the payoff matrix, we will obtain this matrix of summarized delays. Now, for example, explain this matrix element 2, 1. It means that the first player sent his package, one of his packages is followed by first road and the second road. And the second player sends two packages in the first road and both packages follows by first road. In this case, on this road we have three packages and one package is following here. So three packages delay, it is 3 hours. One of packages fallen by at the bottom, so the delay is 2. So for first player, which sent one package on first channel or first road and another for the second road, his delay will be here 3 hours and here 2 hours. So his delay 5 hours. And for second, his both packages fall in by first way, so the delay for each package is equal to 3. So the delay is equal to 6 hours. So that is payoff matrix. We calculate all elements by this way, and we have the game with this B matrix game of this form. The potential matrix, the potential function which corresponds to this payoff matrix, here the same payoff matrix, and that is potential. Why that is potential matrix? Because we can check that the difference between payoffs for first and for second player is equal to the differences of payoff matrix. Ну, for example, let us compare these elements. The difference between these elements 3. See here, the difference between minus 5 and minus 8 also 3. And here let us compare. The difference between 16 and 16 is 0. Difference between minus 6 and minus 6 also 0. So we can check easily that P, that is a potential matrix for this. And for potential games, there is a theorem that if the game is potential like this, in this case the equilibrium in original game coincides with Nash equilibrium in the game with potential functions. So if each player has like a payoff potential functions, and maximum of potential functions corresponds to Nash equilibrium. For example, here we see that the maximal elements here 16, 16, 16. So Nash equilibrium will be here. So first player sent package, one package in the first row, the second package on the second row, and the second player sent two packages in the first row. The same symmetrically when they change by strategies, also that is equilibrium, and equilibrium here also. So this equilibrium corresponds to the case when both players sent one package on the first row and the second package they sent by the second row. So it's very convenient to have potential game, because in this case the equilibrium can be reached by maximization of potential functions. So I skip other examples. And that is the main theorem here, which was proven by Mondarer and Shapley. So if we consider n-player game gamma, and if this game is potential, then a Nash equilibrium in the game gamma coincides with the Nash equilibrium in the game gamma prime, where instead of payoff functions hi, we write here potential functions. And this game admits at least one poor Nash strategy Nash equilibrium. And x prime, which gives the maximum of potential function, is Nash equilibrium in this game. So I skip this. This class of potential games sufficiently large because it was proven by Rosenthal that in congestion games such function, potential function, exists. So, and now let us give the definition of congestion game, and after that we will go to transportation system. So, asymmetrical congestion game is n player game gamma, where n capital, that is the set of players, m capital, that is the set of objects, Si, that is the set of strategies of all players, where Si means that player I selects some objects from the set M capital. And Cj, that is the function which associated with any objects from the set of all objects and depends on the number of players which select this object J. So the pair function here calculates like this sum in all objects which are chosen by player I, and we summarize the cost Cj, which depends on the number of players Kj which select the object J in payoff S, where S consists of strategies S1, etc., Sn. And the main result here that any symmetrical congestion game is potential and admits a poor strategy equilibrium. And potential in this game has the following form. So the potential here is sum in all objects which have been chosen by players I. And the second sum, that is the sum in all players from 1 to kj, to real number of players which select the object j, cj of k. So that is potential, so we can find the equilibrium if we find the maximum of this function. And small example. So if four players sent unit traffic from point 1 to 4, and capacities of the links are presented in the figure, and if the delay is calculated like traffic divided for the capacity, in this case we calculate potentials in different profiles. For example, S1, S2, S3, S4, potential is equal 8. In profile S1, S1, S2, S2, 6.5, and minimum of potential is if we send traffic, first player send traffic using the strategy S1, the second and third S2, S2, and here S3. So that is minimum, so minimum delay, and Nash equilibrium corresponds this profile. That is a technique how we can find the equilibrium in congestion game. And now we go to transportation system. You see here that is typical example of urban transportation network. So that is my city, Petrozavodsk. It is located on the coast of Onega Lake. Onega Lake, that is very big lake in Europe, the second biggest lake in Europe. And that is a city, that is the public transportation here. The different paths on this graph corresponds to different bus trajectories in this graph. So it is standard transportation network, and that is our object for modeling. First of all, we like to construct the graph which corresponds to transportation network. The graph looks like as presented, the graph presented on the figure. So here the number, that is the stops. The stops for buses, for different routes for buses in the city. For example, the bus number one is going by this way, and the bus number two can follow by this way, etc. So originally we have some transportation graph, and in this graph we have different stops, that is the nodes of this graph, and the links, that is the transportation routes in this graph. How we model the transportation system? So people which are living in this region, they follow in the morning, they follow to the office using by some bus. So first of all, we'd like to calculate the flows of people which follow from one point to another. How to calculate the flows? That is not so easy problem. Mathematically, it means that we have Poisson flow model. Poisson process is characterized by intensity of the flow of passengers. So intensity, it means that it's how many passengers, in mean value, how many passengers came in the stop in some unit time. For example, if but people follow from point I to point J, and we must to determine the flow of passengers which follow from point I to point J, call it lambda ij. So that is intensity of Poisson flow. So people from point I follow from point J, follow to point J. This matrix lambda ij, that is a quadratic matrix, it's called correspondence matrix. First of all, we'd like to estimate correspondence matrix. Of course, it's a big problem because correspondence matrix in the morning is different correspondence matrix in the evening, because in the morning people go to here, from here to here, but in the evening they follow to the back way. And also it depends on the season. So in winter time and in summer time, the flows are different. But anyway, we need to calculate by some way this correspondence matrix. There are some different approach how to do it. One of them, that is calculate. The simplest way, that is to ask people in point I, in what direction are you going? But it was popular in 60s, 70s when this theory appeared. But of course now we must use modern achievements in physical equipment, to use them video cameras, etc., to determine the payoffs. And very good approach to check people in each bus, to check people which enter to the bus and come out from the bus. It is realized, for example, in Hong Kong metro, when you put the card to the machine, calculate the number of passengers which enter in this station, and when you came out, you also put the card to machine. So, and I explained how to calculate this correspondence matrix in this case. So, denote, so for example, we have some experiments, number of experiments, for example, 100 experiments. We calculate x1, x2, etc., xk, r, that is the number of incoming passengers in stops, at stops I from 1 to k in some road, bus road. And the values y1, y2, yk for experiment r, will, that is the number of outgoing passengers at, this, at different stops. Well, of course, at the beginning and final stops, nobody income, come, nobody come in, and nobody came out on the first stop. And let us designate lambda I j r, the number of passengers incoming at stop I. It's unknown value for the moment. The number of passengers incoming at stop I and outgoing at stop j. That is unknown values. We form the table. Here the outgoing passengers and x, that is passengers which come in on the road. And here many zeros. And of course, the number of passengers which outgoing passengers on the point on the stops j approximately is equal the number of passengers which come in on the stops I before stop j, and that is probability or some ratio, some frequency of passengers which come in. It's unknown also, unknown values, which come in the stop I and come out on the point on the stop stop j. To find unknown variables Pij, we can employ the last square methods. We form that this sum of squared deviations, that is constraints, and we minimize in Pij, we minimize this sum, and that is the method how we can find unknown parameters Pij. And we, if we calculate Pij, after that we can calculate the unknown intensity, the passenger unknown number of unknown intensity of passengers which come in on the stop I and come out on the stop j, like a mean value of calculated variables Pij. So it's easier to do, and for example, for Hong Kong Metro, I think they do it like this way, to calculate the flows people in Metro from one point to another. What is the subject of transport modeling? Our goal is to modeling different control parameters. So for officials and for the business, it is important to calculate pricing mechanism, so equilibrium pricing mechanism, required number of vehicles, capacity, and schedule. So routes, traffic intervals of intensities, for bus transportation, etc. That is the main question for any transportation office. So, first problem, service rate. How we can calculate, for example, the intensity of bus movement? So, let us consider the simplest case with two carriers. So, suppose that we know lambda, that is intensity of traffic in some certain road. Assume that two carriers, for us, that is players, they deliver passengers on this road. The strategy of these players, intensity for bus movement, so mu1 and mu2. Mu1 and mu2, that is parameters which depends on the number of buses. So how many buses I need to move, to circulate in some road. Suppose that P is a fixed. P is a fare for transportation. So that is a price for tickets, for example. The transportation cost, for simplicity, suppose that they equal C1 and C2 for one passengers. So for one vehicles. If the service rates of players are fixed, mu1 and mu2, now we go to the game. So we have game of two players, bus company 1 and bus company 2. So if we fixed the service rates mu1 and mu2, in this case, these two buses company, they cover all market, all passengers, and they divide the payoff between two person in the proportion of buses. So mu1, that is service rate of first player, and mu2 is rate of second player. So the proportion of first player on the market, that is mu1 over mu1 plus mu2. The intensity of flow of passengers, lambda. So lambda for this ratio, that is the number of passengers which use the first company. We multiplied it for P, that is price for ticket, so that is the general reward which was obtained by the first company, minus costs for operating in this market. So the second player has the payoff like this, and now we can calculate equilibrium in this game of two person. It's not difficult, and we are lucky because this function R concave, and from here, from game theory, it follows that this game possesses a Nash equilibrium. So from first order conditions, we find derivative of function h1 in mu1 and the derivative of function h2 in mu2. We can find that the optimal, that is first order conditions here, we find Nash equilibrium in this form. So if we have only two players in the market, we know the intensity of passengers flow. In this case, the needed number of buses must be like here. In general case, of course, we have big graph. In Hong Kong, I imagine how big this graph. But anyway, that is transportation graph with n capital stops and it's served by K carriers. Of course, there are some limitation for some constraint for the system, denote by LK the number of routes used by carrier K. So K from 1 to K capital. Lambda ij, that is intensity of Poisson flow. We consider that we know this parameter. That is people which follows from stop I to stop j. Now assume that lambda ij is non-negative. Lambda ii is equal to 0. And p is the price for tickets. CKL, that is the cost for a single trip on road L. L from admissible number of ways. We introduced this function Heaviside, like a Heaviside function, that is delta KLIJ is equal 1 if it's possible to move between points I and J on the road L using the service of player K, and zero otherwise. So if we introduce this function, we can write the payoff function. Firstly, to determine the strategy. The strategy of the player some later. So mu kl, that is intensity of bus traffic of player K on road L. So that is unknown parameters. We will find it from Nash equilibrium conditions. So of course mu kl is non-negative, and after each player K determine the intensity of service in each path from his admissible set, after that we have profile of strategies mu. We know the intensity lambda ij, but people which follows from point I to point j, they can choose any of players, any bus service, depending in this model, maybe some later I explain another case, but in this model, people choose the first bus which first comes to the stop. In this case, if we suppose by this way, because sometimes in some models it's possible that the price for the tickets are different. But if the price for tickets is the same, in this case, it is, we can use this approach. And for us it is important that if we know the intensity of passengers flow from point I to point J, in this case we need to organize the bus service by such way that this inequality be satisfied. So we must to satisfy all these passengers. So we must to introduce so much buses that will be enough to cover all this intensity. So that is the constraint for the possible satisfaction of passengers flow. And now we can construct the payoff function for player K. So if profile of strategy is determined, in this case we can calculate the proportion of passengers which can be delivered by player K. So if you see here the two sums in all stops in transportation graph, so that is intensity of all people which follows from here I is not equals J. No, it is determined is here. So people which follows from I to J, that is this flow, he is distributed in all companies. So the ratio, the proportion of these passengers which follow by player K is equal to mu KL divided for this sum, which corresponds to the case when this forms, these players can transport these players from point I to point J. That is a proportion. That is a proportion of these passengers which be transported by the form K. And if we multiply this sum for the price, we will have the general reward which will be obtained by players K if he uses the strategy mu KL in all his routes. And that is the costs. So, and that is additional constraint which corresponds that the reward must be more or equal than costs. And after that, we can find equilibrium in this game. We are lucky because, again, this game, this wave function is concave, and from general game theory, it follows that Nash equilibrium every time exists among poor strategies. So only the problem how to find the this optimal values. And in transportation models, it's very useful Wardrop equilibrium principle. In general sense, Wardrop equilibrium coincides with Nash equilibrium. But Wardrop conditions are very useful to find equilibrium. So Wardrop principle suggests that the trip time along all existing routes is the same for all road users and smaller than the trip time of any road user deviating from his road. And the average trip time achieves minimum in the equilibrium. So this principle is very useful to find equilibrium. Moreover, the transportation game very often is potential game. So in this case, and Wardrop equilibrium permits to find this potential function. For example, to construct the potential, we need to determine the form of latency function or delay. Delay also, it's very important to optimize the transportation system. How to determine delay? Oops. In transportation models. Of course, it depends. The delay depends on the traffic. Assume that incoming flow of passengers, not players, of passengers is described by Poisson process X with intensity X. Delay determined like a function f of x. So delay depends only of traffic, of intensity x. Delay can be determined like a linear function, like a polynomial function, like a very often delay is equal traffic divided for capacity of the road. Capacity of the road depends on the number of lights, number of crosses in the road, and the length of the road, etc. Very useful so-called BPR latency function, BPR delay. BPR, it means Bureau of Public Roads. It's very often used in the United States. In BPR case, the delay on the road I depends on of x by the following way, like a polynomial function. What does it mean? If x is zero, when x zero, in this case, f of x is equal to ti. So x zero, it means that no traffic. So for example, at night, the road is empty, and if you travel by this road, the time for delay time, it will be equal to ti. But if x is increasing, in this case delay increasing, ci, that is capacity, and alpha a and beta a, beta I, it's possible to calculate using some statistical. But we don't stop in estimating of these parameters. We suppose that these parameters are given. Let us consider the very simple transportation system, which consists of n parallel links, and people follow the flow going from point V1 to V2. So some Poisson flow with intensity x is coming here to point VI, and after that passengers are distributed in these links. So the incoming flow x is decomposed into n subflows. It's clear that xi is non-negative. Of course, sometimes it is zero. If the link is slow, people prefer more fast channels. But anyway, the sum of subflows must be equal to the incoming flow x, and subflow profile we can determine by this way. We have game with pair function which is equal to the delays. So every player is interested to minimize delay. But you see that when the incoming flow visit V1, after that this flow is interested to distribute it. So these passengers are interested to distribute themselves in links and to reach V2 as much as possible, as soon as possible. From Wardrop equilibrium, it follows that all delays in all used links, it will be equal. So that is, you see this example in the supermarket. When in big supermarket, when people collect some goods, they go to the exit, and there are many kasses, and they distribute it with these goods among kasses. But in fact, each person will stay in the queue equal time. So that is Wardrop equilibrium. And it helps us to find equilibrium here. But it's possible to check that this game is potential, and we don't need to find equilibrium by of course, usual way, that is to construct Lagrange function, and after that to minimize Lagrange function in some constraint. But here, like an objective function, can be used potential function. So it's easy to, you can see from here, the potential function in this game has this form. Why? Because if we calculate the derivative, partial derivative of function p xi, it coincides with the player function of player I. So equilibrium problem is equivalent minimization problem with this potential function, with this objective function. So the idea is that when the flow is going here, this x, capital X, is divided for some subflows xi. But this, in equilibrium, this xi will be minimized this potential function. So now we can calculate Lagrange function, write Lagrange function, and minimize Lagrange function using the Karush-Kun-Tucker theorem. For example, in our case, when we use BPR delay, like here, we have potential function in this analytical form. Let us suppose that all parallel links, in this case, they ordered ordered by parameters t1, t2, etc., tn. It means that the first row is the fastest and the last row is the slowest. So we like to minimize this function in this constraint. We construct the Lagrange function, use Karush-Kun-Tucker theorem, which gives the first order optimality equations like this.
And this theorem helps us to find our drop equilibrium or Nash equilibrium in this case from this construction. So this incoming flow in the equilibrium will be distributed among the first k channels, the first fastest channel, where if we denote this values vk like a sum of unknown xi k plus 1, this unknown parameters, in this case we find k from the condition that incoming flow must be located between these two values, and the conditions from which we can find the unknown subflow intensity are satisfied by this equation.
And now we go to another problem. So we consider two problems which are traditional for transportation model. So the first problem, we determine the model how to find the optimal service for competing forms in the market, if we know the correspondence matrix, if we know the flows of passengers in the city. And the second one, after we determine the service rate, the service the optimal service rates of participated players. After that, we can determine the equilibrium distribution for flows of passengers in different routes. And another problem that is economical problems. What is the price for tickets can be installed in this market? Consider, for example, air transportation market. Now here you see the fragment of Russian air transportation market. You see here Siberia of Russia, and people from different cities must like to visit another cities in using by some flights, some air transportation. There are some companies which solved this market, and here appear many specific problems. For example, from which city to another city, which cities can be selected for the transportation for this company? What is the price for service? How many planes must be installed in this market, etc. It's very important questions for existed companies and for new coming companies also. Let us consider this market and let us give the description of this market. The customers, also we have some graph. We have nodes of this graph. That is the cities in the country. And the people which are living in these cities, they like to visit some cities in this country. So the customers distributed in the nodes of some graph, G, V, E. As usual, V, that is the number of nodes or vertices, E is number of links. The nodes of the graph G represent the hubs, that is bus stops, airports, railway stations, etc. Edges correspond to transportation links, so railways, car routes, airlines, etc. So, for example, for air transportation in the market, no links. So, first of all, if the market is empty, first of all, companies must create the links. After that, they must create the prices for the service. This characteristic must be determined if you like to modeling the market. So the customers in node VJ, that is passengers who use this kind of transportation. Service is delivered only if there exists a link between customers. So if no link, no service. It's possible to calculate the number of customers in node G, in node VJ. But demand it not equal the number of customers. For example, in Hong Kong, 7 millions of people are living in Hong Kong. No, approximately the same, but not all people use the air transportation. Maybe I don't know. Each year, maybe 4 millions of people use this air transportation. But how to determine the demand? We know that, for example, in this node we have 7 millions, but we don't know the demand, how many people use the air transportation. But of course, it depends on the population in the city. So demand depends on the capacity not only of one node, but also of destination, how many people live in destination points. So we will calculate the demand on each link. So if the link EJ, that is link between two cities, between V1 and V2, we will calculate demand like a function which depends on both cities. And we can calculate it. It is some later I show you how it's possible to do it. Okay, in this market we have N companies, that is players. They deliver a service. So each player I has MI units, so MI planes, and he must distribute these planes in this market. So in some links. So they distribute resource. If the player distribute resource to a link EJ, it means that these two nodes are connecting, and there is a game in this edge. If at least two players use this this link, so competition. So if we a node EJ, that is transportation network for player J, in this case a competition occurs in the market only if there is an intersection, so intersection is not empty, of two forms. So two players, they compete in the market between these two nodes. If this edge belongs to the transportation network of two players, in this case we have competition and game theory approach in this link. So on the first stage the players chooses the links in which they will compete, and on the second stage they announce the prices for the service in each link. So if two firms or three firms, they use the service on the link EJ, in this case they announce the prices, and after that customers select the service which is more comfortable for these customers. That is a strategy of players here. So this price, that is a strategy. So PRJ, that is the price of player I on the link EJ. So that is strategy of player I. After that we form the profile of strategies, and after that we estimate the number of demand, the part of demand which select the player I in the link J. Demand depends on this profile of prices. How to determine the some later I explain how it's possible to calculate the part of the market which prefer the player I. If we determine some way this ratio of all demand which select the service I, in this case if D EJ, that is general demand, that is this part of market which belongs to the player I in the link EJ. Denote XIJ, that is a distribution of player I on link EJ. So XIJ is equal 1 if player I uses the link EJ, and 0 otherwise. If so, the number of players on the link EJ we can calculate like a sum of XIJ for in the sum summarizing in all players. So player I with MI units of resource on the graph G attracts the number of customers like this. So that is this part, that is the part of demand which served by player I, and that is all his part of all his market of the part of all demand in this market for player I. If we determine that the part of the market of demand which belongs to player I, in this case we can calculate the reward of player I. So if the player I operates in the market EJ, in this case PIJ, he installs the price for service PIJ, that is his reward. But also there are some costs, costs for gasoline, for salary for pilots, for service, etc. So we consider that the costs in the the costs of player I in the market EJ, they proportional the number of passengers which choose this company. So finally we have the game from three stages. So on the first stage, the players simultaneously distribute their resources using allocation XI. That is the first strategy. On the second step, the players simultaneously announce the prices for the resources. On the third stage, customers choose a preferable service and the players obtain the payoffs HI depending on the transportation network and prices. That is a game. How to calculate this function MIJ? In economical research, it is often used logistic distribution, like here. It follows from some statistical physics, based on statistical physics, and have this form. So that is exponential form, but here it's, it must be minus here must be. So if the price is bigger, the number of passengers which prefer this service is less. So that is the part, if it must be here minus, so that is the part of the demand in the market EJ which prefer the service I of company I. And we are lucky that that the this pricing game. So on the second stage we have pricing game. The players announce the price for the service in each market EJ, which is used by this firm. And It's we are lucky that this pricing game with pair function HRJ is a potential game. So it's enough to find maximum of potential function of special form. So if this game is potential, so in pricing game, there are some properties of this game. In the pricing game with additional player, so if we introduce additional player in this pricing game, so if some company likes to join to the market EJ, the equilibrium prices are decreasing for all players except the new one. So if we calculate, that is prices in the previous pricing game, and if new person, new company join this market, in this case, the prices in new game will be less than in original game. Also, in the pricing game, if new company join this market, the optimal payers also decreasing for all players except the new one. And now let us I show some examples related with real markets in Russia and in China. So we have players that is airlines operating in the market. We have transportation. We have some flights in this market. We can get information from internet. All parameters for airlines can be found also from internet. And after that, we can analyze this market, trying to improve the rewards for some companies. But of course, rewards depends on many, many factors. But anyway, it's possible to modeling and to analyze the situation using the game theoretic approach. Well, for example, for Russian airline market, I showed you this picture before. So we have Siberian market, air market. This market is characterized by this table. So that is price for the flights. That is mean value for the price for tickets in different flights. That is mean deviation, median of this distribution. Of course, the prices spectrum is very very huge, but anyway, the mean value is 9,000 rubles, minimum of prices 1,500. Maximum price 21,000. If people follows from Novosibirsk to Vladivostok, it is expensive. But if short flight, for example, from Krasnoyarsk to Novosibirsk, it's sufficiently cheap. So flight time, the mean value for flight time 3 hours. Standard deviation 2 hours, so minimum that is 40 minutes, maximum 15 hours. Frequency flights is 2.5, so minimum that is one flight, maximum that is 14 flights. It's popular cities, many people traveling. So distance in kilometers. Mean value is about approximately 2,000 kilometers. Minimum, that is 200 kilometers. Maximum, 7,000 300 kilometers. That's from Novosibirsk to Vladivostok. Income is income of these companies for the flight 27,000 and minimum 14,000, maximum 50,000. Population in these cities, mean value is 500,000. Minimal population is 44,000, maximum 1.5 million. That is Novosibirsk. So that is airline companies. That is the players which operate in this market. Well, you see, no, that is big company S7, Ural Airlines, Ruslan, UTAIR. Other companies are small. They fly from this number of airports. So, for example, S7 flies from 11 airports and has nine routes. And Ural Airlines served in nine cities, in nine airports. So that is characteristic of this market. That is the cities, not all cities, but part of the cities which are used in this market. So the nodes in this graph. So that is population of people of these cities. No, you see the biggest city is 1.5 Novosibirsk. And airlines which are soft in this market, 10 airlines. And here fixed route Irkutsk, Novosibirsk. In Irkutsk, Novosibirsk, five companies soft this market. So flight time is between Irkutsk and Novosibirsk is different for different companies. And flights per week, you see here, distance in kilometers, like here. That is the prices for the flights. It was we modeling the situation in 2014. It was the price. Well, now it's slightly changing. So in this figure we calculate that is, of course, equilibrium prices and market prices are different. So that is market prices for different flights, and here the equilibrium prices. Equilibrium prices is not real prices because we don't consider here the prices for gasoline, for salary of player of pilots, etc. But if we consider that the structure of these figures, biased prices, that is prices which are calculated from market prices minus mean value of mean value between these two differences. That is biased prices is here. And you see there is some correlation between equilibrium prices from game theory and real prices for tickets. And the same we are doing for China airline transportation market. You see here Urumqi, Qingdao, Shenzhen, etc. You see here that price in yuan for this models. So the mean value is 1000 yuans, standard deviation 500. So minimum prices for minimum price for tickets 540, maximum 2009. So for big distance, flight time is mean value two hours, minimum 40 minutes, and here maximum 6 hours. Frequency, you see here the minimum one flight per week until seven flights per week. Distance from 300 kilometers to 3,000 kilometers. And population is here from 2 million until 3 million. And also there is some correlation between equilibrium prices, like here, and market prices, depending on flights. So that is references. But on the first lecture, I showed full reference list for this lecture also, for this workshop also. Thank you very much.